It was Friday lunchtime at the iron ore mine in Brumadinho.
It sounded like an earthquake, a sound of a bomb. The ground shakes like an earthquake.
The dam collapsed, releasing tens of millions of tons of sludge and rocks, a torrent of toxic waste that had built up over years and now buried everything in its path.
Teve pais que nem não chegaram a conhecer seus filhos. Nada vai trazê-los de volta.
In under a minute, the mud swept through the mine headquarters and the canteen.
Can you imagine? All of that mountain was rejected.
All of that? That.
All of that.
Yeah.
It's about 10 or 12 meters from reject.
10 or 12 meters of sludge, toxic waste.
Eu imaginava que ele poderia estar soterrado. Soterrado assim, num lugar. Querendo ajuda.
The sludge continued onwards, taking out a hostel and a bridge, and snaking its way through farmland and villages.
Quando eu lembro que eu vi aquelas árvores caindo lá, passando a lama lá, caindo. E as pessoas tudo lá embaixo, que a gente conhecia, todo mundo ali embaixo.
Uma mulher lá morreu abraçada assim na pilastra do...
Parts of Brumadinho look like a modern day Pompeii. A town struck by a sudden and devastating catastrophe. But it didn't need to be like this. Investigators claim the mining company knew the dam wasn't safe. And this wasn't the first time a dam like this had collapsed. People were, in effect, living on the slopes of a man-made volcano. Why?
Let's be clear about what this isn't. This is not a story about an industrial accident. It's a story about a system of economic development, about a whole way of life built upon the ever-increasing extraction of finite natural resources. It's a story really about the relationship between human beings and the planet we inhabit.
Morning and evening, the freight train rumbles through, laden with ore. This is a town built on mining. Ever since the first Portuguese colonizers discovered vast wealth buried beneath the fertile ground, mining has been the mainstay of the economy here. Brumadinho is a small town, a tight-knit community. This disaster has left no one untouched.
É meio que inacreditável. A gente trabalhei lá durante 15 anos. Eu perdi muitos amigos. Perdi uma família.
Adriano Braga was part of this extended family. He went to work that Friday. He never came home.
Uma pessoa muito inteligente, muito talentosa, que estava no início da carreira, no início de criação de família. Ele tinha acabado de se casar, planos de ter filhos, né? Então, assim, uma fatalidade, uma pena.
Jobson was only 8 when he was sent out to work. In his 20s, he got a job at the mine. It was his ticket out of poverty.
Era sinônimo de conseguir construir alguma coisa na vida, de ganhar um dinheiro, de construir uma família, de ter uma casa própria. tem um carro. Então, assim, todo mundo queria trabalhar na Vale.
Jobson left the company last year. That decision may have saved his life. Weeks after the disaster, Adriano's body is still missing. At a public meeting, they're looking for someone to blame. A similar dam, part owned by the same mining company, collapsed 3 years ago. The company, Vale, vowed it would never happen again. It was an accident, they said. People don't accept that anymore. The local mayor tries to placate an angry audience. A man accuses him of being in the pocket of the mining company. The mayor says, without revenues from mining, Brumadinho simply won't survive. Vale is the town's biggest employer. It's also the second largest mining company in the world. It wields enormous power.
As the locally elected politician, it's your job to hold the company to account, to make sure that they abide by safety regulations. Why did you not do that?
Isso não foi feito porque a responsabilidade não é do município. Então, mas nós não dão licença, não dão nada. Então, a gente, na realidade, fica com os braços amarrados. Não tem autonomia de nada, o município.
Ok, but these people are saying that you work for the mining company.
Vê lá, nunca fui subordinado à Vale. Nós estamos batendo pesado neles com as indenizações.
Among the crowd is Caio Braga, cousin of Adriano, whose body is still missing. Caio is a local councillor. Even before the disaster, some of his constituents were concerned about the safety of the dam.
Havia rumores, boatos, mas ninguém fala abertamente. Então, como vereador, né, eu tenho como situação julgar o mérito.
He drew up a list of questions and sent them to the mining company. They only wrote back after the dam collapsed.
Eles não me deram essa documentação, por quê? Porque realmente a barragem estava com problema.
The company, Vale, told us that the questions were complex and that they needed more time. This is a case study in the limits of democratic power.
Porque hoje o político que fiscaliza uma mineradora é politicamente ruim para ele, porque a mineradora emprega, fala que a gente está atrasando.
The type of dam that collapsed is known as an upstream tailings dam. It's really a lake of sludge and mining waste held in place by a series of small dikes made out of compacted earth. As the mine produces more waste, new dikes are built on top of the old, forming a sort of pyramid. It looks solid, but inside it's liquid, a disaster waiting to happen. Weeks after the collapse, firemen continue to search through a wasteland of toxic mud.
You can see the conditions they're working in and also a sense of scale here. This is six guys searching through this vast area of mud. And all these weeks later, they're still pulling bodies out.
One body.
You found one body here today?
Yes.
Was it a whole body or was it a body part?
Todo em parte.
Parts.
Body parts.
Right.
Yeah.
A torso.
Yeah.
And arms and legs.
Arm part of the jaw.
Part of the jaw.
Yeah.
That must be psychologically very hard work.
em
your head? É um desafio psicológico trabalhar nesse tipo de situação.
More than 100 bodies are still missing. Among them, Adriano Braga, whose family we met earlier. That morning, he had had breakfast with some colleagues before heading to the mine.
Então a gente conversou sobre o que o Adriano estava fazendo, um exame periódico. Ele tinha feito uma... sabia dos objetivos deles, o cara super família. Assim, tinha um sonho de acabar de construir a casa dele, amava a esposa dele.
Adriano's friends believe he was in the staff canteen when the dam collapsed.
We have there about 200 or 300 people lunching in the exact time of the accident. We found a very big number of bodies on this site.
Right here?
Yes.
Where the they were swept inside the canteen, yes. All the way from that mountainside over there, yeah. Down here.
The Vale mine is closed for now. Brumadinho is in crisis. More than 300 people are dead, 1% of the population. The environmental cost is still uncalculated. But the freight trains keep on rolling. Extraction continues at other mines nearby. Growth, development, nothing can stop the juggernaut. Could the tragedy at Brumadinho have been prevented? Some believe it could. 40 miles to the north lies the capital of the state of Minas Gerais. This is the center of Brazil's mining industry. Here, some say, the laws are made not by elected politicians, but by the mining companies. We've come here to meet someone who says she's seen firsthand how politicians give priority to the mining companies' interests. In December, a month before the disaster, there was a meeting of the State Council on Mining Regulations. The purpose was to debate whether to grant a license for Vale to expand its operations at the Brumadinho mine.
We tried everything to say it's not possible to give this license because this complex, this mining complex, have problems.
Maria Teresa Coruja voted against the expansion. Hers was the only dissenting voice.
It was terrible because I am sure that people should not die because we try every time to say that, stop that crazy thing. Why? Well, we try, we said to you, and no one listened to us. And after that crime, we still listen and we still see that authorities and that people with the power of making change, they still doing the same.
An investigation is underway. The state prosecutor told us that the mining company hired two outside contractors, Tractor Bell and Tuv Sud, to inspect the dam last year. Her case has focused on the question of who knew what about the conditions of the dam.
This is your deposition, right?
That's my recommendation.
This is your
recommendation. I signed it.
This is you signed it, right. And it says that in September, Tractor Bell inspectors basically said it wasn't safe.
Yes.
Yeah. And then what happened?
And then when Tuv Sud was contracted, and Tuv Sud declared the stability.
But so basically, Tractor Bell said in September last year it's not safe, and Vale, the mining company, said, well, you're fired then, and they hired a different company to say it's okay, it is safe.
Yes.
Tuv Sud told us their assessment was thorough, and they defended their inspection report. Since the collapse, a Tractor Bell engineer has told a hearing that their inspection didn't indicate an imminent risk of collapse. But it gets worse for Vale. The mining company wrote up its own financial risk assessment which noted that the risk of the dam collapsing was higher than acceptable, and it estimated a cost to the company of $1.5 billion.